Thank you. First of all, I would like thanks to organize committee to give me this opportunity. So this time I talk about new minimal surfaces in H cross R. So first I explain some previous result in minimal surface theory in H cross R. And second part, I will explain new construct, new complete embedded minimal surfaces in H cross R. And finally, I classify some of them with respect to the total curvature. So let's start part one. So I want to explain what is H cross R. So yesterday already Professor Jun-sang Park explained very well in what is H cross R. And H cross R is one of Thurston's H geometry, and already these three are space forms, and H cross R and S cross R PSL2 covering and Heisenberg group and SOL3. So I focus on H cross R. And H cross R is simply connected homogeneous Riemannian manifold with four-dimensional isometric group. So three translation about H2 and one translation about vertical R axis. And H cross R is also symmetric space. And Euclidean space, we can consider R3 like R2 product R. So we change R, Euclidean plane by hyperbolic plane. So this is in some sense generalized to Euclidean space. So hyperbolic plane has several models. So H cross R has also several models. But in this talk, I pick the cylindrical model. So the I consider Poincaré disk model for H2. So the whole space is a solid cylinder. And the boundary of solid cylinder is a cylinder, so I call the ideal cylinder. And I want to explain what is a minimal surface. So let's surface sigma is minimal if and only if its mean curvature H is identically vanishes. So a physical meaning is the mean curvature is vanishing is the every point P in surface minimal surface sigma has a small neighborhood which is the least area relative to its boundary. So it means every minimal surface and every point it can be realized by SOR film. So there are already several examples, minimal surface. And the first one is totally geodesic. That means the shape operator is identically vanishes. So by Swam and Dubiana, they prove that the only horizontal plane, so H2, and vertical plane, these two are only totally geodesic in H cross R. So more precisely, the vertical plane means we take a geodesic in H2, and let's say more precisely, the gamma in H2 is a geodesic. So gamma product R is a vertical plane. And second example is a vertical catenoid. The vertical catenoid is a surface of revolution. And these two are catenoid in H cross R. And one interesting thing is the height of these two ideal boundary is cannot excess the height pi.
You were saying that those are
only
the minimal.
Yes, minimal surface, yes. And in H cross R, we can construct a helical, yes.
The previous page.
Yes.
So what's the difference between
the two? So this difference is we can compute the neck size. Neck size means we take origin here, and the radius of this 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 distance, and the radius is bigger than this catenoid. So we can one parameter family of the catenoid. So the neck size become to zero, then the catenoid become to two punctured hyperbolic plane. And we also construct the helicoid. Helicoid is a ruled surface by horizontal geodesic along the vertical line. So this is quite similar to a minimal helicoid in Euclidean space. And this is obtained by Bunoa Daniel, and this example formulated by hollow circles. Hollow circles mean this is a Poincaré disk, and take the point at bound infinite, and this one is hollow circles. So this example formulated by hollow circles only. And the height of this ideal boundary and this another boundary is cannot exceed the pi. And recently, the Philippe Morabito construct the Costa-Hoffmann mixed type surface in H2 cross R. So we already know in Euclidean space the classical this example, and he using the gluing method. So he construct this example in H2 cross R. And the next one is the shock type surface. So we take a ideal polygon in H2, and this is a four edges, and this polygon has six edges. So we can construct a shock type surface more precisely. The first one the first one means this is H2, and take a 4-point ideal boundary, and this is a geodesic connected these two ideal points, and we can consider this domain. So we can find function u defined on the domain omega to real number r. So the graph of u is a minimal surface in H2 cross R, and the boundary value is approaching this this geodesic become the plus infinite, and this value is minus infinite and plus infinite and minus infinite. So we also consider we compute the length of this side. So obviously this geodesic, the length of this geodesic is infinite, but we compute we take a hollow circles at the boundary, and we omit this part and compute this length. So the A plus infinite means the sum of these two lengths, and let's say A1 and A2. So length A1 plus length A2, that is A plus infinite. So we also define the B minus infinite. That means this edge B1 and B2, then length B1 plus B length B2. So if A plus infinite and B minus infinite is the same value, then we can find this example. So this polygon, the regular rectangle, then this condition satisfies. So we can find this function u. So the graph of function u is a minimal surface that called a shock type surface. And one of fundamental theorem in Euclidean space is a Bernstein theorem. So function u defined on the whole Euclidean plane, and if graph of u is an entire function u is an entire solution of minimal surface equation, then u is a linear function. That means the plane is only entire solution of minimal surface equation. So we call this the Bernstein theorem. But in H2 cross R, the Bernstein theorem does not hold because the gamma is a continuous Jordan curve in ideal boundary. Then we can find a unique minimal vertical graph over hyperbolic plane. So more precisely, this is an ideal cylinder, and this is an ideal boundary of horizontal plane. Then if gamma is a graph over S1 like this, then we can find a unique minimal graph over this hyperbolic plane. So we can choose many Jordan graph over S1. So there are many entire minimal graph. So the Bernstein theorem does not hold. And this theorem called Jenkins-Seddon type theorem. So by Golang and Rosenberg, they construct there exists a solution of minimal surface equation in the polygonal domain D, and I already said AI, this one, and BJ, and if A gamma is A plus infinite, and B gamma is B minus infinite, so these two values are equal, and each inscribed polygon P in gamma, this condition hold. These two condition hold. We can find function u satisfying the minimal surface equation. So this is a Jenkins-Seddon inequality. So one of the well-known open problem is Shen conjecture. So that means the Heinz proved that there is no harmonic diffeomorphism from H2 onto complex plane C. And the Shen conjecture, there is also no harmonic diffeomorphism from complex plane C onto the hyperbolic plane H2. But Golang and Rosenberg, using this theorem, they construct in H2 cross R, there exists entire minimal graph over H2, which are conformally equivalent to the complex plane. So this is a counter example of Shen conjecture. So many mathematicians focus on the minimal surface theory in H2 cross R.
Yes.
The Heinz proved that diffeomorphism, harmonic diffeomorphism from hyperbolic plane onto the complex plane. But Shen conjectured that there is also no harmonic diffeomorphism from complex plane. It changed from H to the C. And from C onto the hyperbolic plane. So that is a Shen's conjecture. But in this example, gives a counter example about Shen conjecture.
But it's from H2 to C, but here also H2
to C. This example is like this. Some this is not real picture, but this is a graph of U, and U define the whole H2 cross H2, and the graph of U conformally equivalent to the complex plane C. So if we find this example, then we construct, we consider the projection of this example onto the H2. This gives the count example for Schoen's conjecture. Yes. So this is a conformally equivalent to C, and this is a conformally equivalent to H2. So this gives the count example. So now I explain new complete embedded minimal surfaces in H2 cross R. So by Osworth and Rosenberg gave some property about finite total curvature in H2 cross R. So let X is a complete minimal immersion in H2 cross R with finite total curvature, then the immersion at sigma is a conformally equivalent to the compact Riemann surface minus some finite point. And the third component of normal curvature, let's say N3, becomes to zero uniformly at each puncture. That means every end of this complete minimal surface with finite total curvature converging to the vertical plane. That means the N3 becomes to zero. And the total curvature is a multiple of 2 pi. So the total curvature is zero or minus 2 pi or minus 4 pi and so on. And we already know the vertical plane is totally, total curvature is zero. And this example is a total curvature is minus 2 pi. And if the edges, the number of edges is 6, then the total curvature is minus 4 pi. So we have each number, we have already examples, but all of these are simply connected domain. So the Osworth and Rosenberg question is there a non simply connected complete minimal surface of finite total curvature in H2 cross R? And in particular, is there a minimal annulus of total curvature is minus 4 pi? It's like quite similar to catenoid in Euclidean space. So I answer this question. So the example I named K-noid in H2 cross R. So let K is an integer bigger than or equal to 2, and there exists a non-simply connected complete embedded minimal surface satisfying the first one. The total curvature is finite and the number is like this. And the second one is the surface is conformal equivalent to the K punctured two-dimensional sphere. And the surface is symmetric about K vertical planes and one horizontal plane. So after I will show a picture so you can understand what is meaning of this one. So first step is I construct a semi-ideal Schacht-type surface. So I consider domain bounded by origin 0 and P1 and P2 point at infinite. So domain, we can consider the triangle domain here, and the boundary value is this edge is 0 and this edge is 0 and this edge is plus infinite. So I use the Saub and Dubiana result. The omega is a convex domain and G is a bounded function everywhere except the finite point. then there exists function u satisfying the vertical minimal surface equation and the same ideal boundary. So first, I consider 0, 0, n because I want to using the previous result. So I consider the this value is n first. Then we found a minimal graph satisfying this ideal boundary. Then we have a nice barrier function. So this is a minimal graph. And this ideal boundary, the value of this ideal boundary is 0. And on the this geodesic, the value is plus infinite. So this example can be barrier of this minimal surface sequence. So we take n become to plus infinite, so we get minimal graph. So and this example called Avrashi's minimal examples. So we can construct this this minimal graph. We call the semi-ideal shock type surface. And using Gauss-Bonnet theorem, and this example has total curvature is 1 minus k over k pi. So we can compute the total curvature. And I want using the conjugate method. So sigma is a simply connected surface, and x is a conformal minimal immersion. And n is a normal vector field over this minimal surface sigma, and j is a complex structure. That means it rotates by angle pi over 2 on tangent plane. And s is a field of symmetric operator each tangent plane. So actually this one is a shape operator. And t is a projection of the normal vector, normal killing vector d dt onto the tangent plane. And nu is a projection onto the normal vector field n. So this is the Pythagorean theorem. This is equation holds. And we said S theta like this. And that means the shape operator changed by angle theta, and T theta is changed by T angle by angle theta. Then the Daniel proved that sigma is a simply connected surface, and n is a normal vector, and s is a symmetric operator on minimal surface sigma. It is a shape operator of minimal surface, and t is a projection of killing vector field on the tangent plane, and nu is a projection on the normal vector field. Then there exists a unique family, x theta, is a conformal minimal immersion such that the metric is the same. That means x theta is an isometric deformation of x. And the shape operator is s theta, and n theta is a normal vector field of x theta. So in particular, the theta is pi over 2. We call the conjugate surface of previous surface x. And the conjugate surface has a very special property. Let's say the swapping property of conjugation. That means the vertical geodesic line of surface sigma become to horizontal line of curvature of conjugate surface. And the surface meet orthogonal to the horizontal plane, and the converse is also true. And second one is the horizontal geodesic line become to vertical line of curvature of the conjugate surface, and the conjugate surface meet orthogonal to the vertical plane, and also the inverse is also true. So if k equal 2, the previous semi-ideal shock type surface like this, and we take a conjugate, so this vertical line become line of curvature of horizontal plane, and this surface meet orthogonal meet the horizontal plane, and the horizontal line become to vertical line of curvature, and R3 become to vertical line of curvature. And the crossed type theorem means the sigma is the minimal graph over convex domain, then the conjugate surface is also minimal graph. So this is a minimal graph over convex domain. So this is a minimal graph over some domain. So the picture is like this. So I'm using the cross type theorem. Then, and we well-known theorem is Schwarz reflection principle. So gamma is a horizontal line or vertical line. We can rotate by 180 degrees, and we can extend it by smoothly. And the gamma is a line of curvature, and surface meet orthogonal to the plane. Then we can extend it by mirror symmetry. So we get this example, and we apply the Schwarz reflection principle about this plane and this vertical plane and this vertical plane. Then we get this surface. So this is a the two-noid. So if k equal 3, we get this example. So we call the three-noid. So, and this time we consider another the minimal graph like this. Then we take a conjugate and we extend like this, and we apply the Schwarz reflection principle. We get another surface. So the k equal the positive integer, and alpha is a positive number, then there exists complete embedded singly periodic minimal surface satisfying the fundamental piece is a finite total curvature, and the fundamental piece is a genus 0 and 2k ends. So I want to little bit skip this theorem. Yes. And we already know many examples. So the natural question is we want to classify some of them. So with Magdalena Rodriguez, so we prove that M is a complete minimal surface of total curvature is minus 2 pi in H2 cross R. Then we already know this example is this one. So we prove that the M is a shock type minimal surface over a domain spanning an ideal rectangle. So the sketch of proof is we can prove that M has only one end, and using the maximum principle and the ideal boundary property, then the M is an actual graph over a domain spanned by ideal rectangle. Okay, I want to stop here. Thank you for your attention.
Any questions or comments?